Tonight, rescue teams in Thailand are working around the clock, scrambling to free a youth soccer team from the flooded cave they've been trapped in for more than a week. Just found alive yesterday. Two Navy SEAL divers, a doctor and a nurse, are tending to the boys inside the pitch black cave now. Rescue crews have been bringing in food and water. Authorities there are looking at all of their options, none of them easy, to get these boys home. Anna Korn is out front in Thailand. So Anna, we're hearing that it could be months before the boys are rescued because of monsoon season. What's the latest there tonight?
For sure, Kate, they are preparing for these boys being trapped inside this cave for potentially 4 months. That's to sit out the rainy season. It's monsoon season here in Thailand. We've had a break in the weather, but they are expecting rain, heavy rains in the next couple of days. Now, they are pumping water furiously from the cave, hundreds of thousands of litres every single hour, and they are making progress, reducing those levels. But they are now looking at ways to get the boys out, perhaps using a full-face oxygen mask and being let out by those Navy SEALs. So if that happens, if they can get the boys feeling comfortable, this could happen a lot sooner than we expect. Now, as for their spirits, we understand that they are in good spirits, which is quite remarkable considering we are now entering day 11 of this saga. You mentioned those Navy SEALs. There are at least 7 to 10 Navy SEALs who have been by their side ever since they were discovered. And we also understand that there's a real camaraderie amongst these team members and that they are extremely resilient. But, Kate, as we know, they are desperate to get out and be reunited with their families.
It's remarkable they'd be in good spirits right now. Just remarkable. Anna, thank you so much. Tom Foreman's now out front. Tom, this is a system of caves, and it's more than 6 miles long where the boys, where the cave part of the cave where the boys were was 1 mile in. More than a mile in. Explain what rescue workers are working against.
They're working against darkness and cold and rushing water and time. Let's take a look at the structure of this mountain and the caves inside, what they have to deal with in terms of challenges there. This is where the boys went in. They're more than a mile into the mountainside, more than a half mile down, and there is, as far as we can tell, no really complete diagram of the inside of this cave, no really good map. But if we took a hypothetical cross-section, we can explain why the boys are trapped there and why it's so hard to get them out. Let's say they came in down here. As they walked through the cave, they would have gone up and down and up and down. And then when the monsoon rains rushed in, the water started filling in those gaps. And in some cases, as you can see right there, would have made it completely impassable. How many there are like this, we don't know. Are they as big as a house, big as a football field? We don't know. We just know the professional divers are taking quite a bit of time getting from here to there. And if they want to bring the boys back out that way, as Anna just mentioned, they face real challenges. First of all, some of these boys are unable to swim. So yes, a diver could tow someone through there, but he'd still have to be used to wearing a scuba mask and being underwater for perhaps quite a period of time. Some of this water is very murky. It's hard to see. There are heavy currents. There are cramped passageways, all of which complicate that process, and ultimately, all of which could lead to panic, Kate, which could be dangerous for both the rescuer and the person being rescued.
Absolutely. So what about the alternatives?
Well, Anna mentioned a few possibilities there. They could take the model from the Chilean rescue of 2010. Remember when those miners were caught underneath the ground there? They bored into the mountainside and were able to reach them and bring some of them out that way. But remember, there were 3 different boreholes, and it took more than 2 months before these happy reunion scenes finally occurred. So maybe they could go with another option, as, again, we heard a moment ago, keep supplying these kids, move them to maybe a slightly higher, safer platform there. But again, you're betting on the waters going down, and there's no sign that's going to happen anytime soon.
Yeah, betting on Mother Nature here is a scary thing. Thank you, Tom. I really appreciate it. Out front now, someone who knows, Ben Remnants. He's a cave diver on the ground in Thailand, part of the team trying to figure this all out. Ben, thank you so much for taking the time. You saw firsthand what the conditions are. Help us understand what it's like.
Imagine a Colorado River underwater and with zero visibility. These were the first days when we arrived there, so we had very little hope of getting there. But as the rain stopped, it got better. The visibility cleared up and the current got less, and we actually made good headway, and we made those, like your reporter said, 1.5 miles into the cave to the place where the kids were.
How long did it take you to get in there?
4 hours.
Wow. You know, I spoke with one diver today who said that cave diving is tough for even some of the most experienced divers. It takes training, months of training. How difficult is it going to be to teach these kids how to dive when some of them don't even know how to swim, if that's what this comes down to?
In comparison, we dive caves every day. We do a lot of cave exploration. We would not dive this cave in any conditions at all. That's why there's no fixed lines in there, because it's only being done when it's dry and safe. So diving this cave is a Mount Everest of cave diving. We had to lay heavy fixed lines for about 1.5 mile into the cave, and then that was the hardest job of all. So to connect a lifeline with the kids.
Wow. There's now a doctor and a nurse that are in the cave with the boys and their coach. Can they survive in there for 3-4 months until the floodwaters recede? I mean, that's a real option right now?
They're running out of options. The conditions were quite good. The heavy pumps were doing their job. The water was receding quite a bit. It dropped 6 foot in the last days. They were hoping it would be low enough so they could literally swim the kids out. But the water has risen. Yesterday, the water came up a bit, and they're expecting heavy rains, which would flood the entire system. You've seen the base caves on footage. If the rain starts, these would all flood, making the distance to the entrance double, which makes it impossible to get to the kids. So yes, they would have to be literally locked up for 3-4 months until the rain stops and the water resides. They would take big packs of food with them. For this time.
Real quick, Ben, you said you were surprised that they were all alive and in good condition. I think everyone probably is. Do you know anything about how they spent those 9 days in pitch black before they were found?
I have a team of doctors that are consulting me. They were a bit worried about their mental state. Obviously, 10 days with no solid food, no light, probably bats flying around against them, which is not very stimulating for the mental health. But surprisingly, yes, they were one of the British team actually serviced there first, and they were actually talking English with them, asking them what day it is and do you have food? We're a bit hungry. So yes, they were in very, very good shape. Obviously, muscle atrophy, too weak to walk, and that's what they're doing right now, supplying them with a little bit of food and slowly getting their powers back.
It's a good news and a scary news story. I mean, all wrapped into one. Thank God they're alive. Really up against some challenges still. Ben, thank you for what you're doing. Thanks for coming on.
Thanks for having me.